In section 9.3, we will look at one strategy used to replicate extrachromosomal materials in prokaryotic organisms. Due to the circular nature of plasmids and the circularization of some viral genomes or infections, rolling circle replication is a common strategy that is used. Other methods can be seen as well, but we will only focus on this one here. Rolling circle replication begins with the enzymatic nicking of one strand of the DNA at the double-stranded origin site, the DSO. In bacteria, DNA polymerase 3 binds to the 3' hydroxyl of the nicked strand and begins to unidirectionally replicate the DNA using the unnicked strand as the template. It displaces the nicked strand. Completion of the DNA synthesis at the site of the original nick results in the full displacement of the nicked strand and leads to the synthesis of the nicked strand using the single-stranded origin site, or the SSO. Once this replication is finished, it will result in the full replication of the plasmid DNA. Note that this is happening extrachromosomally as well, and so you could have multiple copies of a plasmid that accumulates within a single cell, where you're only going to have one copy of the chromosomal DNA at any one time. The mechanisms used to distribute the plasmids in the daughter cells are also not the same as the chromosomal DNA. They're not segregated equally. And over time, if there's no selective pressure to maintain plasmids, they can often be lost from the host. In the next section, we'll begin to look at DNA replication in eukaryotic systems.